Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Josh, and this is your stimulus check update for the next stimulus package for Thursday, March 4th. I hope everyone is having a wonderful Thursday afternoon so far. In this video, I'll be discussing updates in regards to the current relief package and the third stimulus check. I'll also be discussing the $1,400 direct payments, unemployment, and then I'll be going over the updated timeline on when this bill will possibly be signed into law. But first, if you wouldn't mind real quickly, liking this video, giving me a big thumbs up. It really just helps with the YouTube algorithm in terms of pushing this video out to other viewers like you, and hopefully helping other people like you as well. Okay, so we've just 10 days before the federal unemployment insurance benefits are set to expire for millions of Americans, Congress will need to quickly race to the finish line. Speaking of unemployment, just last week, first-time jobless claims came in at 750,000, which is up by 14,000 from the previous week. At the moment, there are just a little bit over 18 million Americans on all unemployment programs, such as PUA and PEUC. Tomorrow morning, we should get a better idea of the overall unemployment situation as the new jobs report for February will come in. During January, we saw the unemployment rate drop from 6.7% to 6.3%, so it should be interesting to see where it comes in at tomorrow. Okay, so in some stimulus related news, the hope is at the moment that they get a procedural vote in by the end of tonight. By doing so, they can move on to the 20 required hours of debate. But first, of course, by Ron Johnson's request, the bill must be read out loud in its entirety. Being that the bill in its entirety is going to be around 700 pages long, it sure would be nice to have some speed readers at the Capitol. Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer said he'd prefer Ron Johnson to be the one reading it so he could then learn about the stimulus checks, among other aid, in the bill. Senator Johnson, on the other hand, said he wants the bill to be read so then Americans can be educated about all the non-virus related items in this package. In the end, reading the bill in its entirety isn't really going to do much good. Considering it's highly doubtful that many Americans will even listen to the entire coverage, in the end, all this is really going to achieve is holding up the bill even longer. Okay, so in this package, I quickly went to go over some details regarding these stimulus checks. First off, the next round of direct payments are going to be for $1,400, and they're also expected to include dependents, even those over the age of 17, who missed out during the first two rounds. Now, the IRS is going to base these payments off of the most recent tax returns that you filed and that they processed. So, for example, if you filed a tax return for 2019, but you haven't yet filed your tax return for 2020, then in that case, the IRS will base your payment off of your 2019 returns. On the other hand, if you've already filed your 2020 tax return and the IRS has already processed it, then they'll base your payment off of your tax return for this year. Now, one other important thing to note here is that if you earn less money in 2020 than what you did in 2019, then the IRS will make whatever adjustments necessary once they process your tax return this year. For example, if you earned $1 million in 2019, which would have made you ineligible to receive your payment, but then you made only $50,000 in 2020, then the IRS will send you the full amount once they finish processing your tax returns. Also, considering this rule, if your income actually went up from 2019 to 2020, you may want to consider waiting to file this year until you receive your payment. That way, the IRS will base your payment off of your 2019 returns. Once they process your 2020 tax returns, even if you made more money, they won't take away your stimulus check. So, just something to consider. Another important thing to note in regards to these direct payments are when it comes to newborns. If you're expecting a baby this year, you'll also be eligible to receive a $1,400 payment for your newborn as well. However, in order to receive the money, you'll more than likely have to wait until next year to claim it on your tax returns. It's also important to note that your baby will have to be born on or before December 31st of this year in order to be eligible. If it's born even a day later, on January 1st, then you won't be eligible to claim the $1,400 on your tax returns. Crazy how that's going to work out for some people. Also, just recently, the phase-out periods for the next round of direct payments have been changed up just a bit. Previously, the phase-out periods for single filers were set at $100,000, for head of households at $150,000, and for joint filers at $200,000. Since then, because of moderate Democrats such as Joe Manchin fighting to get these checks more targeted, the phase-out periods have changed. Now, they're going to phase out at $80,000 for single filers, $120,000 for head of households, and $160,000 for joint filers. Because of this, progressive Democrats such as Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez took to Twitter to show their displeasure. In a tweet, Ocasio-Cortez said, "Conservative Democrats have fought so the Biden administration sends fewer and less generous relief checks than the Trump administration did. It's a move that makes little to no political or economic sense and targets an element of relief that is most tangibly felt by everyday people, an own goal." Democratic Senator Ron Wyden, on the other hand, still calls the lower threshold a win for progressive Democrats. In his eyes, progressive Democrats won the overall battle just because checks aren't going to be reduced as much as Manchin was hoping for. Originally, Manchin was trying to get the direct payments reduced to single filers earning $50,000 per year and joint filers earning $100,000 per year. In the end, they were able to keep those amounts at $75,000 for single filers and $150,000 for joint filers. Now, it's being said that because of the reduced phase-out periods, around 11.8 million adults and 4.6 million children will now no longer qualify for the relief payments. This will reduce the bill by around $23 billion, which definitely is a lot of money, but all things considered, when the entire bill is $1.9 trillion, this is a very small piece of the overall pie. If you want to reduce this bill by $23 billion, I'm all for it, but we probably shouldn't be taking away from aid that goes directly to Americans. Just my opinion. As far as the timeline for receiving the $1,400 direct payment, it looks like we could be receiving them anywhere in the next few weeks. At this point, it looks like the Senate is going to be working well into the weekend to get the bill passed through their chamber, at which point it'll then move on to the House. The hope is, at the moment, that they'll be able to have it passed through both chambers and then on President Biden's desk at some point next week. Once the bill is signed into law, payments should begin to quickly go out, considering the IRS already has everyone's information from the first two rounds. The only thing that could possibly cause a delay is the fact that they're also processing tax returns, but even with that, I wouldn't think that should slow them down. So, in the meantime, while we wait for this bill to be signed into law, hopefully within the next few days, all we can continue to do is hang in there, stay strong, and hope for the best. Alright, so on that note, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. If you did enjoy the content in this video, and you'd like to see more videos like it, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. It is completely free to do so, and it's a great support to me. Also, if you'd like to receive 4 free socks from Webull, with 2 of them valued all the way up to $1,600 each, or 1 free sock from Robinhood, just for signing up and linking your bank account, please feel free to claim those free socks by clicking the link in the description box below. And finally, if you join Rakuten with my referral link in the description box below and spend at least $20, Rakuten will give you $20 cash back. This means that you can buy an item through Rakuten with one of their referral links, such as Macy's, for $20, and Rakuten will give you $20 just for making that purchase. This is just an incredible deal that we'd love for everyone to take advantage of. Okay, so until next time, I'll see you guys and hope you have a great day today.